Engineering videos and technical solutions, BTech and Master Engineering thesis guidance, simulation of projects using different software such as MATLAB, PVSys, Helioscope, ETAP, and many more. Detailed videos on these topics and much more available software such as AutoCAD, Revit, and SketchUp. Be part of our family by subscribing to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, like our Facebook page, and visit our website. PZ Engineering, passion to excel.
Hi, welcome to the PZ Engineering channel. In this video, we are going to show how to simulate PV array system using PSO controller. If you are not yet part of our family, please be part of our family by subscribing to our channel, share our content, like this video, and comment. This is our system, which is already built. All the components can find from the library browser. Here we have our PV array. There we have our control, which is PSO. We have the workspace and have our measurement side. Now let's see the values or the parameters with our PV array. These are the values of our the parameters. If our bypass diodes, if our MOSFETs, this is our inductor value. If our MOSFET doesn't change anything, our diode. We have our capacitor. We have our resistor, which is load. And here we have the signal of PV array current and PV array voltage. There it supplies to calculate the power. It's the PV array power. And from there goes to the control. Here we have our control. Yeah, the input voltage and current. It's open. This is our code. We can just follow everything there. as I say, you can just follow step by step. Okay, the video cycle, and then use the saturation maximum minimum. You decide when it comes to PW mode generate. There's the, it's the output. Then from there it comes to the MOSFET to switch. Then it comes to the measurement. I think that everything's okay. Let's check it for a bit. This is our solar irradiation, the temperature. Let's check again. Now let's run. These are all the values. PV array output, the voltage current, the load current, the voltage load. Let's check the voltage, the load voltage graph. Now let's run again. Now let's change the irradiation value, which determines the output voltage. As we change the irradiation value, we can see the output output voltage or the output power is different.
and let's keep on changing to check the behavior of the system. See, yeah, it's 3.8 times. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, share our content, comment this video, and like.